have been here from day one of this women's conference, and I'm so grateful to have her to come again.
Thank you.
It has been a stormy year for her. Been sick, been in the hospital. But how many know that she has the victory? The devil is defeated, and God has the last say. I said, God has the last say. The devil might see doom and gloom over your life, but if God be for you, who can be against you?
Amen.
make you whole. And you can dance, you can praise him. Hallelujah, glory. You know, it's time for tabernacle, got started. We started with drug addicts. Hello, here somebody, huh? My members were drug addicts from the neighborhood. God watched them, checked them up, cleaned them up, and brought them to be ministers and deacons and disciples for the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't turn them around. They might not be the way you want them to be, but I declare to work with them. As your doctor may say, if they put the word of God in them, they'll do you good. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm excited tonight. I give all the praise to my Jesus. Glory to God. I bless him tonight. He is the head of my life. And I give him praise. I want to thank God for being back again. Thank you, God. We look forward to it. Thank you, God. But I know there's many out there that can do more. But we came to lift up Jesus. We came to let you know that there is no spirit like the Holy Ghost is. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I may not have a whole lot of money to give you, but I got a whole lot of love to give you. Hey, glory to our living God. Love will lift you up. Love will bind us together. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Our favorite neighbor, he was no prophet. Glory to God. He wasn't no apostle. Huh? He was just Brother Harrell. That's a long time ago. But look what the Lord has done. Leaving me, but the devil is alive. I'm going to talk until God said that's enough.
That's it.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God. I saw your theme. I saw the theme said, thank God for my pastor. Thank God for
it.
Assistant pastor. I thank God for our Sister Olivia. She would like to do put no title on her, but we're going to call her Sister Olivia. We thank God for her. So if I don't preach, I'm surrounded by preaching. I got my apostle. Hallelujah. I got my Pastor McNeil out there. I got my Pastor Springer up there. I got a whole lot of preachers here today.
All right.
Glory to God. When they see me can't go on, they just come up and take this mic and take it to the next level. Is that all right? Glory to God. And don't say that one got to do everything. And you got help in the building. How do you know we got help here? We are not going to be able to carry it all the way. So on the way, our God, to our destiny, we got to drop it off.
Amen.
Let somebody take over. Glory to God. I would hate to die, carry all of this in me, and never mentor nobody. I want to mentor somebody that they know that God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory
to
God.
Mentor.
Thank you, God. Sometimes we get jealous, we get selfish. We don't want to pass the torch. We don't want to pass the baton. We want to hold it all for ourselves. You better know when it's time to give it up. Set yourself down and train somebody. Glory to God. For so many don't have nobody to carry the ministry on. Why? Because they don't want to do it all. You can't do all in this ministry. Get away, you out of it. Glory to God. But when you trust God today, when you put your life in his hand. Glory to God. I'm going to stick to your topic that you have. I love it, I love it. Glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Dean, dress up or still mess up. Oh, God. I agree with you, Amanda. I agree with you. And we will tell the truth today. We down in high position, we still mess up
too.
God had to clean us up. Hallelujah. Sometimes we think that we got a whole mama and we got to smoke cigarettes. All of that is just defiled the body. Glory to God. But when God clean you up, you will not continue doing those things. So I just bless the Lord. Messed up? Hey, God, but I'm still dressed up. Glory to God. We give God praise. We going to do, we can all talk about different character of the Bible. And that's good. That's where we get our information, and that's where we get to know how to carry ourselves in the Lord. Glory to God. When the Lord called me, I was messed up. Yes, I was. I was messed up because I didn't know Jesus. Glory to God. It doesn't matter what I was doing or where I was, he still cleaned me up.
Yes, he did.
Did he clean you up?
Amen.
I need to talk for a minute too. And we are going to go to a book that we don't usually talk about this woman. Ah, God. We don't even mention her name. But she is one of the greatest women in the Bible. Glory to God. We talk about Deborah. We talk about Esther. We talk about all of the great women that God had used. Glory to God. But we never preach or talk about Rahab.
My God.
Rahab.
Rahab.
Oh, God. She was the greatest woman in the Bible. Messed up?
Yes.
But
great.
Isn't that something? Glory to God. Rahab was a messed up soul.
Yes.
She was illegal. What is your occupation? Anybody know your occupation? What do you do for a living? Glory to God. Every one of us got a different occupation. But Rahab's occupation was, she was a harlot. That was her occupation. Glory to God. She was good at it.
She was good.
She got paid for it. She got paid good.
You're good when you get paid for it. That's right.
So if you're going to be a harlot, be a good one.
That's right.
Hallelujah. If that's what you want to do, then you ought to get Hallelujah. So Rahab wasn't no woman that didn't get saved. The Bible says she lived.
That's how she lived. That's how she lived. Glory to God.
Out on the wall. She was on the wall. She was recognized. Glory to God. If you want to do this kind of work, make sure you do it right. That's why that. How do I do it? Because I got to make a living. She was a prostitute, the Bible says. Glory to God. I just want to give you a little history on Rahab. Thank you, our evangelist, Arel. That was a good time. You got a lot of messed up women. We got our churches all messed up.
Yes.
We got a lot of, God, I'm going to be nice if I can. Hallelujah.
Help somebody.
I'm going to tell you about Rahab's story. Right. Okay, Rahab was a great woman. And the Bible says she was the most beautiful woman in the world. She was pretty. Glory to God. Yes, still. And she had a problem.
Yeah.
She had a flesh.
Yes, she did.
She had a stone in her flesh. She was beautiful. Girl got any man that she wanted. Glory to God. But God, in his love, using her through the lineage to bring Jesus to that ancestor. Isn't that something messed up and God still used you greatly?
Yeah.
You all messed up and God still, he didn't take the time and just put a drop.